This is Josh Hope with Mimaki USA. Today we're going to look at setting up Rasterlink 6 to use the LAB value for a named spot color coming out of Adobe Illustrator. The power behind this technique is that by using the LAB value, you're always requesting the same color and you're allowing the RIP to convert that color to a CMYK build based off the media, the profile, and the print mode on the printer each time you print. So you're always requesting the same color, but the output is being adjusted depending on whether your gamut is larger or smaller depending on your printing condition. If we take a look at this file inside of Adobe Illustrator, we can see that the green element in the design is actually colored with Pantone 369C. If I double click that swatch, it will open up the swatch options, and I can see that the color mode is book color and that the build is 62L, -39A, and 60B. If I take this file and I now open it inside of Rasterlink, I can check to see whether those values are being passed correctly. So I'm just going to open up that file. I have it saved as an EPS. Rasterlink processes the file and brings it in. If I come here to my color replacement and I click on the icon, I can see that it does see the Pantone 369C color. When I select it though, I can see that the input color is a CMYK build of 65-10-100. This is the default CMYK value and it doesn't relate in any way to what I'm actually going to print. What I mean by that is that if I request 65 cyan, 10 magenta, and 100 yellow on a printer that has a much larger gamut and a printer that has a much smaller gamut, the output will be very different. What I want to happen is I want my color to be requested as the LAB values that were set up in Illustrator and allow the RIP to convert that color to CMYK output based off of that print media and mode. In order to do this, I need to take a look at the Tools menu inside of Rasterlink 6 and take a look in the Color Collection. Here in the Color Collection, I can see that I don't have any entries for Pantone colors. So I'll start by creating a new Color Collection. I'll click the plus icon. It's going to ask me for the type. I want this to be a spot color, and I want it to be an LAB value. For the collection file name, I'm just going to call this Pantone and hit OK. Now this color collection name is not important. You can name this anything that you want. This is just going to be a reference for Rasterlink 6 and for you. We can see here by the check mark that it's going to use this Pantone color collection that I've just created, that it's a spot color collection, and that it's defined by lab. We can also see here that I'm allowed to modify this. This is important. Some of the pre-built color collections are set to be modified, set to impossible, which doesn't allow me to edit them here. You'll see when I select my Pantone library and modify is set to possible, the input and output value is editable. So what I'll do is I'm going to register a new spot color name, and this name needs to be exactly the name of the color as it comes in from the file. This is case sensitive, so I want to match it exactly. So Pantone 369C. Now for my LAB value here, I want this to be exactly the same LAB values that I saw in my Illustrator swatches. So I had an L of 69, an A of -39, and a B value of 60. When I click register, I now see the input as Pantone 369C and the output as L69, A-39, B60, just as I see it in my Illustrator file. I'll click close here, and back in Rasterlink, I can see that when I select Pantone 369C, I still don't see my LAB value. All I need to do is select the properties icon, right mouse click the job. I'm going to delete all data. I'm going to open the job back up. So I just have it saved here as an EPS. When the job comes back in, I'll select it. I'll come back to color replacement. And when I select that color, I can now see that my output is 69L minus 39A and 60B. Now this may seem a little bit confusing, but because I'm doing this through the color replacement, it's looking to see what color is coming in and what color does it want to go out. The output here is not the output of your printer. The output here is the output of the file that's going into the RIP. So it is now going to request from the RIP that when it sees this color, it's going to request 69L minus 39A and 60B. That will be converted internally by the RIP to a CMYK output build. That output build, again, will be defined by the substrate and the print mode of the printer that it's printing on. And this should help to ensure that each time I request this color, I'm going to get the closest build that I can to the actual Pantone color that I want.